Well, this is strange. Good thing I got up at 5:30, because they're going to be here at 6. Oh, I just showed up now. Only an hour and 45 minutes late. Oh yeah. I gotta make sure you guys get those fucking sheets off the roof a little better, because, you know, that was part of the fucking operations, right? If he said, fucking, no, there's not gonna be time for that, then I would have been like, okay, well, I'll find somebody else. You know what I mean?
For what?
For taking those sheets off the roof. Like, we can't just send them singing down and crunching into the ground, because, like, that is not gonna fucking work.
Today, we're gonna put both the ladders together and.
Well, I don't give a fuck what happens. We can't be doing what we did yesterday. That's not gonna fucking work for me. And it's fucking 7:45. You said you're gonna be here at 6. What happened?
You text me.
Very nice. Well, don't wreck any more of them sheets.
Yeah.
I'm fucking serious.
Quebec City, what Victoria, happened? Halifax. We service more kids here.
What happened?
Programs. And we don't get any government funding. We get a huge part of our.
She's fucking warm. We're almost done. No one sheet up to go in the front and then just go. I'm gonna get the metal shears for going around that. Do you have shears here?
Yeah.
Plug into an air hose or whatever? Or any type at all? Do you?
Yeah.
Fucking right. We have to go nowhere then.
Can't go any closer.
No, up in the middle, like straight, straight down. Look, I want to see how fucking square we got it, because it ended up 34 and a quarter at the top, 34 and a quarter at the bottom on this far end. Like, I mean, fucking down to the millimeter.
Looking on an angle that way, like, bring your guy over here. It'll show all those lap screws on an angle. It looks fucking really good. If you ever take a picture of it, because they're all in a line, right?
It's in with a pizzeria.
My boss got shears. Mm. I can just snip it, but it won't look as good.
I got like some.
It looks like great though, right at the corner and the one rib where it goes up. So it's completely flat with the whole shit.
I think I got some. I got these ones, but they're like an offset, so it's gonna curl the one side out.
That's what we want, actually. The outside edge, I'll go from top to bottom. That's exactly what we want. That'll make the cleanest cut that won't rust.
And that should
you can get it. Those are power fist, eh?
Do the trick.
A set of these, like the good ones, are like $399 with tax.
Yeah.
So the only tools I don't have, I've got ones that hook up to an airline.
You got extension cord and shit?
You know what? I might not. I have all my stuff with this other job.
Fuck.
Whatever you do, don't drop those shears.
Well, I am real particular about my extension cords. No stepping on them, bending them, twisting them, fucking with them, fucking cutting them, dragging them.
Oh, no.
I'm real particular about my extension cords. Real bad. Really just munching the fuck out of that leaf shit, eh?
Oh no,
just crunching the shit out of her. Is there fucks?
Oh, it'll go right back down to how it was. It's a loon though.
Bass. What happened?
With metal you shouldn't have on there.
Well, the fucking.
I'll tell you what. When it's
But the keys
there.
Off these maple trees fucking just fucking plug my eaze troughs full of shit and then, but I can't do that three times a fucking week.
And it goes from 2 degrees to zero when it's raining a little bit out. Well, it sits on top of that shit rather than going in the gutter, and then it fucking water dams back into your roof, right? But you have that foam enclosure, so it's not as bad. But if we got like a lot of rain and it's near freezing point but not quite, that's when it's bad. Personally, I don't even really care for them. Because I mean, they still get stuff underneath of them anyways. You're better off just cleaning your troughs every year.
Well, yeah, but once those maple trees start fucking shitting out those things, done. Yeah, right.
One run with the leaf blower, done.
Well, if it was that easy, that's what I would have done. Fucking idiot. But anyways, we got some friggin' mail. Let's check out our friggin' mail. Yeah, we did. Yeah, we friggin' did. Oh, I can even get on the shot. Oh, deck pictures. Pictures. Miller Racing. Hey, Pug One, I've been watching your movies since February of 16 and became addicted instantly. I love watching your builds. You build stuff in the shop and big fan of the jumps. You've inspired me to buy a GoPro and record our ATV rides, and when my dad races at Son of a Bitch Speedway, the picture I have enclosed was from March 2016. At an indoor car show, tell Tiff and BBD. I said, hi, keep up the amazing work. Cheech me out on Instagram at Johnny2112. Oh, yeah, that's a little bit of a Rush reference there. 2112. Sorry for the sloppy handwriting, smoke cigarettes. Your biggest fan, Jonathan Miller. It's okay to shout me out on Instagram. Oh, much obliged. Appreciatory. Right on, man. Right on. Yeah, you did. You did. Put that with the lettures. This with the deck knolls and that in the gear badge. We'll open this guy here up and saw it. Put it dots. Oh, Dick. How you doing? So this is a TIG finger and what do they call it here? It's just the stubby TIG pack there. Hopefully we'll be able to, oh, some big dirty tungstons in there too. Holy, holy, right on, right on. Yeah, so we went to weldmonger.com, welding tips and tricks, got some torch, stubby torch and arse coals and a TIG finger, because the friggin' son of a bitch gets pretty warm, so as you can like jab your fingers on there and use that for propping off stuff. You know, if you're welding on this box, the box is getting super hot, well, you put that on there and you can, you know what I mean, and then it's more awesome. How you doing?
Oh, fucking
shit. You quit?
Can't fucking make another shit. Gotta wear the fucking harnesses too.
Well,
we don't need to hook up, we just need to throw it on so it looks good. Who gives a shit? Well, we got this far, we don't want to get shut down now. That day to wear this one back.
And a bonus.
Until they fucking show up with 7 man, fucking everyone jumps out with a camera, man. I'm telling you, they get you every fucking time.
So let us daunt what we can saunt on the old weld nurse cool. See, there's a 17 on this, so I was just assuming that it's a 17 style torch, because that's what all this mumbus jumbus is about. We'll bring that disc inside, we'll put the TIG fingers over there, we'll crack that sumbitch open, and we'll have a look and see Donovan sees. Oh yeah, look at that. Them wrecking my tools. That's fucking ridiculous. I gotta keep giving these guys tools. Like, I just want my roof done. If it wasn't for that, I'd be like, man, you gotta go. But yeah, support support other YouTube channels, especially good ones like Welding Tips and Tricks. The guy to go to for the welding. The welding friggin' Struxions. Look at that, boys. Oh, friggin' rights, eh? Just look on it, friggin'. Get right into the tight friggin' spots there. Yeah. Frig yeah. Scores! And we'll be able to not burn the friggin' snack out of ourselves now, too. Scores! Double scores! But yeah, we'll just stick around with this stuff, get more in the hankerings of operatings of the equipments, and even got like a little bouton head so you can make it even smaller. Yeah? It would just have that little nugget on top. Yeah, we did. When your tungstens get all low, I had just had that one, so I just buzzed her off, so I was gonna try her out there, but frig yeah, man. We did. And we got some stuff to put in our drawer, but we got our hypertherm consumables, and now we got our TIG welder consumables or parts or bits or whatever you want to call them. But yeah, I'm still on babysitter the dick mode, but yeah, friggin' right. So we got TIG finger. Oh yeah, I guess I should put some of this stuff away. Are you quitting?
Not even close. Right at the end. Final stretch.
What, is he sitting in the AC or something?
Yeah. Getting all fucking ready to go.
Was that your idea to put all the garbage in the cigarette butt?
No. That's why I actually asked you if that was garbage.
Where is the actual garbage? I mean, all this shit.
Out front in the bins.
That's why I asked you, because I seen all that in there.
It's like you were trying to fucking catch my shit on fire.
Is that what that is there?
So now I can't fucking go because I need soffit screws. Like, holy fuck, dude. So how many of these do you need?
I need these right here. I need, fuck, the whole handful.
Where are they?
They're going all around.
Are they olive or are they white?
Hmm?
Going all the way around the chimney stack.
Yeah. The little screws that they had screwed into the plate up there that they had around the chimney stack, they did it wrong, so we'd take that piece off, put a new piece of metal in, but we need those little screws, because these will go right through the metal and fucking, you know what I mean, stick out. These ones are just, get it right through the metal. Attach them. I need the little screws, these ones here.
Yeah, but the way that you do it is you put it the proper flashing around that chimney, and then it's, you don't need that shit. Like, so you're just gonna like cobble up my fucking chimney stack?
No. It's how they had it before, like when you.
Well, I don't give a fuck how they had it before. I'm getting a new roof, bro.
No, you obviously don't understand.
Oh yeah, I obviously don't understand, clearly. Holy fuck. This is fucking crazy.
That's what I need screws for. I can't put these through that. There's no way to attach that with these.
Well, don't they sell those fucking assholes anymore?
Well, yeah, and I would have got them, but you got the materials, right? This is what I was saying. That's why I don't let fucking customers get my materials usually, but I wasn't gonna argue with it over it.
That's not even the same profile, for fuck's sakes. How is that going to work?
I wouldn't bring this up. You wouldn't answer me down there, so I just fucking went with it. There's nothing wrong with it, but...
Oh, yeah, there is.
Well, yeah, there is. You wouldn't answer me.
I wouldn't answer you. You never asked me about that.
That flashing should come out. But you just sat there and then you walked inside, so... I just went with it. It's not a big deal. It's still okay. It's just ugly, that's all. Inwood Customs. He's even got, what do you got, two companies or what?
Man, I don't even know what to say about that. That's fucking ridiculous. We need to get rid of this. Get rid of this and put a fucking new one on. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Oh, we gotta do this and that, and then not.
Yeah, you want me to do all this for free, bud? Holy fuck, dude. What do you mean?
Yeah, I want to do it for free, man. Free. Yeah, I want you to do work for free. I asked you to quote my roof, and you gave me a quote.
Well, just so happens there's another sheet left. Like, we can fucking fix it.
Well, that'd be nice.
Okay, well, I was just gonna come down, man. It's just tacked. Relax. What do you mean, fuck? You're talking quite a bit of money for one of these stacks. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, you don't need a stack. You need the flashing that goes around the stack. What's wrong with the stack?
No, that's not how it works. That's what they did. That's not right. This here should not be like this. It should be a one hole.
So like the plumbing stack and shit, you got to replace the whole pipe going down into the building.
No, just from here inside, it disattaches. But this piece right here is expensive as fuck. That's what I'm saying. I can make it work. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just ugly. But who the fuck's going to be back here looking at it? Nobody. Right?
Well, yeah, but the profile of this, is it, like, how are you going to fix that? Like, how are you going to make
that?
What
do you mean? This here, right. There's special screws that pull these two together, and you caulk it like everyone else would do. Some people put it right over top, even. Like, they don't even run this over top, right? Like they did before. They just caulked all the way around it. I took the time to tuck this one and lap this one, right?
You took the time? Well, how else are you going to do it?
Just put a new stack in, but like I said, there's really nothing wrong with it. It's just appearance wise, but no one's even seen it back here, so I don't have time to fucking sit around with that, man. I got way too much shit going on right now. But there's wood right here. As soon as I put the screws in this, it's gonna be tight and look a lot nicer than that, obviously. So before I actually fucking do it, I want to see what you have to say. That's bad.
Yeah, really bad.
Okay, well then go buy a stack. I don't have time to keep doing that, that's all. I can leave it like this tacked. That sheet's still fine. All I gotta do is put another one on here. There's an extra sheet down there. I mean, it worked out perfect end to end. I'm not gonna like I fucked up here. It's not a fuck up at all.
Yeah, it just needs the flashing around the stack. That's all.
It is a flashing.
Yeah, I know. It's the old shitty flashing.
I know.
On my new roof.
That down there, and you wouldn't fucking answer me.
What the fuck are you fucking talking about? I wouldn't answer you, dude.
I fucking said it. You just walked inside like you've been doing them the whole fucking job. Don't fucking get started.
Holy fuck.
With me.
All right, man.
Yeah, well, it is, bud. You did it three times to me.
You fucking guys asked me where the garbage is fucking 55 times. The cigarette bin's full of fucking garbage. Are you fucking kidding me?
No,
I'm not answering the same questions fucking 55 fucking times.
No, you're just an asshole.
Okay, right on, man. Right on. Okay.
Yeah, okay. You're going to take your shit to fucking
up,
bud.
Yeah, right on. I didn't say hold on, I said right on. Fucking hack my fucking roof, you fucking goof. We'll fucking see. Fucking idiot piece of shit. Yeah, right on. Fucking joker. What'd you find out? My goodies?
What do we got, Amazon?
Uh-oh, sewing machine.
Ah. You're all set, bud.
Right on, thank you.
Holy boys, would you look at that? Trapped your roof dick scene. Full of shit. Beg my pard. Beg of the pard.
You gotta like fold that edge over or something, or is it just stay flat?
No, you wanna leave it like that, or else it'll crimp it even worse. Once all the screws in, it won't look as bad as it does right now. It's because that foam enclosure's in there, right?
Yeah.
Once I hit it every 2 feet, and I hit it in between those 2 feet marks too. Nothing's level up there, right? It's not gonna look perfect no matter what you do. The cap's on there, 99% accurate. I have to go with the feet, so. Or else it'll come to grown up.
So that just the ends fold down to keep the birds out the end, or
yeah,
what?
Yeah, I cut it. It's just got to be folded. I don't have the right bar here for doing it. I have a special fucking, well, I'm sure you got one too. A little folding clamps.
Vice grips.
Exactly. I don't want to try and hand do it, or it's going to crank a little bit short. But anyways, yeah, I don't know. We'll be back first thing in the morning to fucking with the caulking and finish screwing all the missing screws.
Oh, did I wrap that right?
No.
No, that's a roof.
What's going on?
Yeah, that's how we do them all. Hoses, fucking cords, everything for roofing. I've always done it. Can I be able to fill this up really quick, bud?
Go ahead.
Thank you.
See all the cords? Not all twisted up and wrapped up like a goof. So I like my cords. Oh, what do you got there? You've been busy. Got a piss hole and everything. You fucking disgusting. Are you supposed to be canning him? Are you supposed to be canning him? You busy. Oh my goodness, I'm starving. Well, anyways, the old lady reminded me that Pig Iron had to sail, and there's a table she wants for sewing nonsense or some friggin' thing, so we're going to get that, plus there's other stuff for Pugwan, plus friggin' we're going to see Jimberly tomorrow, and he's just about passing away, so we're going to pick him up some stuff, apparently, even though he does deserve it, because he quit Inwood, but friggin' my snack, we got to go there anyway, dump off some of his crap. Me crawdad saying, get your shit out of my place, Jim, you son of a bitch. But
we'll take him a whole bunch of extra stuff that he can just have to deal with.
Yeah, you just have to throw it in the garbage. You got a dumpster at your apartment, don't you, Jim? Holy shit, three-wheeler ejected. He's just looking at me like, what are you doing, buds? Back of the park. Couple of the dirty old cant twists, make my bird. Oh, it's for fucking tabbies, eh? We just drill tons of the tabbies into herself. That's a good deal. Careful. We should cut the fingers off this and start road raging on the 907, so I'm terrible. You bessin'. Got all type of goodies today.
That's good.
You really schlong-hoggled us on the flyer this week.
He's like, the edible kind, I'm not picky. I said, LOL, yeah, you are. He's like, not when I'm actually starving to death, LOL. I suck a fart out of Joshua's ass right now. I'm so hungry. I'm like, haha, disgusting.
Ugh. Fuck, you imagine sucking a fart out of Joshua's ass? You're so fucking starving. That was real starving. Real bad.
The buzzers went off and the lady went to go, but their kids were too far gone, and she's like, meh.
I wonder how many times these have been plunged in somebody's mouth. Yeah, get them all these just gross fucking soups, eh? Get them some like clam chowder and shit.
I like clam chowder. I do
that. That's fucking dicked. Clams are disgusting fucking things that open with a tongue inside of them. You don't eat that.
Same as you.
Close a mouth. You'd get him a box of this, and he'd be able to eat for a month. 10 bucks.
Got him a box.
You should get him this. For his sandwiches, he can cut a little Elmo face. For his sandwich. Mm. Are you packing? Are you packing? Are you packing? Fucking disgusting. I just got a whole movie of that guy just picking his butt. Terrible. I think he was picking. He loves picking. Terrible. Traffic jam. But he loves picking. while he was branching and picking and digging in Walmart. I love picking my butt, but not in Walmart, eh? That's my song. It's called I Love Picking My Butt, But Not in Walmart. Well, sometimes in Walmart, but not just out in the open. Out in the open, willy-nilly, stabbing my finger in my own butt, eh? Terrible. That's a fucking terrible, disgusting. He did that for my movie. But maybe that'll be the thumbnail, eh? Guy's picking his butt. Are you pecking? Must be scratch your sack Wednesday. Oh, there's the picker. Oh, he was just, oh man. He was just rooting around in the, he did too. Oh, he did. He did, tip word. He was just picking and I got it on a movie. And then I also got him on a movie taking a little sample and just helping himself with his bare hand and the thing, and he sampled and then he took it and he's eating it. Oh, I should tell the Walmart lady about the guy who was picking and then stuck his bare hand right in the thing. How you doing? How you doing? Hey sir, don't eat those crispy things in there. I saw a guy picking and then he went and put his bare hand in there after he was picking.
Oh, did he? Oh.
Yeah, that's disgusting. Where is he? Oh, there he is right there. See the guy on the phone?
Yeah.
That's him. See, oh look, he's picking again. Are you picking? Is he pecking? Hey, he was pecking. You saw it? He saw it. Tip forward. He was pecking. I saw him again. I saw him again. He was pecking. And then he was going to stick his bare hand in the thing and get a sample.
You should have asked him to pick the other one.
Yeah. Oh, pardon me, I just gotta pick myself out one of these. How are you doing?
Good.
Not too bad. Just picking myself out some hummus. I love picking out the hummus.
What's the date today, you know, brother?
What's the date today? It is September 7th, right? Wednesday. Wow. Wednesday the 7th, good day today. September. Is it rotten?
No, 50, we're good.
Oh, I'd hate to get squirms in my bum, end up having to go picking. Ugh, oh, I just got a waft of picking stink. I went and talked to him and told him stuff about picking out my hummus and stuff. Oh man, ew, it smells like dumpster juice over here. Those tomatoes are fresh. Hope you're happy, Jim. How much this cost me, son of a bitch? I put the fruit and the bread on the bottom. The boy's starving to death. He's passing away, so we gotta.
He lost 10 pounds.
He said he'd eat his sister's fart.
Right out of his ass.
He's picky and he said he didn't care what I got.
We'll give you all kinds of food. You just gotta lick Robus's back beard. Oh, I love these kinds. There was this guy, he's on his phone over there, and I saw him picking real bad, like he was really getting a dig on.
Okay.
And then he went over by the samples thing, and he opened up the guy, and he took a couple, and then he's walked away eating them, and he just like punches his bare hand when he was just picking, where he shouldn't have been picking. He did, I saw it. What happened? What happened?
I know, we've seen your thing on YouTube.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
What happened?
Oh, we know what you look like now, and that's not allowed in.
Why? What
just
happened?
In case. You're not allowed to videotape or take pictures inside a Walmart.
Why? What happened?
I'm not saying what happened, you just can't for security features. For security features, nobody can do videos or take pictures. In
Since
here.
When?
Since
Who said
the
that?
Open.
Nobody said that to me.
Nobody knew you were doing it.
Is it because I'm ginger?
You never knew, you never let people aware of your camera was on. So by law, it's against the law.
It's against the law?
It is. It's a security feature.
Security feature?
Yeah. For our store, understand, it's security. That's not allowed to be on in the store. I'm just letting you know. And after it's been on YouTube, now we know what you look like. So
we look like.
Just asking you.
Well, I'll just wear a disguise.
So now we're asking you, please don't have it on.
Right on. It's against the law, she told me.
Oh.
Oh, I love that. I'm like, why? What happened? Oh, there's the waters too, eh?
I think she was racial because I'm a ginger, to be honest with you, but I was just trying to help out. I was catching dudes picking and then taking the sampners. Well, they're not even sampners. You're not even supposed to have sampners. You're supposed to friggin' take a bag and buy it. Take it to the thing, and you like that kind, you buy it. You don't just plunge your hand in your ass and then plunge it in there. Yeah. You know what I mean? And then friggin' just have yourself a bit of a sampner. You know what I mean? Nicole, right? But any words, apparently it's nighttime at friggin' 6:30 now. I guess it's 8:15. Holy, but Jimberly scored something terrible. Look at all the stuff. Maybe he won't pass away anymore. He's not gonna pass away now. Maybe he'll come out to Inwood and visit and not be such a pissy pants sometimes. I apologize. Oh, friggin' rights, boys. Check those out. Look at them cant twisters, eh? Holy shit, so expensive. Oh my goodness. But I love those kind of terrible. So a 2-inch, 4-inch, and 6-inch now. Almost got myself the stainless steel ones, but oh man, are those ever expensive. But check out this magnetic organization. Got a couple guys in there. Maybe we'll set that up by the mill, and then we can put like different types of earls and different, you know, signatures for the different fangs. Hopefully they got the roof sealed up. They best. Look at the quality finish on this stuff, boys. Holy, you can't get that anywhere but Big Iron. That's top of line equipment right there, boys. But anyways, boys, beg my pardon, no cheats. Here you go, another dick. Until tomorrow.
Don't let the Walmarts get you.